Welcome to the Amgen Biotech Experience Program. My name is Ali Katarna, and I'm the site coordinator for ABE Massachusetts. Today, I will be discussing Laboratory 3. During this laboratory, students learn about the critical role that the enzyme ligase plays in creating plasmids. DNA ligases can join the ends of the restriction digest fragments to create plasmids with the desired RFP and antibiotic resistance genes. Laboratory 3 allows students to join the fragments that they produced in Laboratory 2 and create a plasmid that has all the correct components needed to produce the protein of interest in Laboratory 5. When engineering plasmids with eukaryotic genes, biotechnology professionals rely on many different types of enzymes. The successful ligation of the gene of interest into a plasmid is crucial to being able to ultimately produce a therapeutic protein. Similar to Laboratory 2, the water bath is a key piece of equipment necessary for this lab. The first thing that you should do is recalibrate the water bath to 70 degrees Celsius the day before the lab. The day of the lab, you want to turn on the water bath early in the morning so that the water can be adjusted to the correct temperature. Secondly, you want to make sure that you have enough water inside your water bath. This is because we're increasing the temperature to 70 degrees, and thus we'll have a higher rate of evaporation. The high temperature is used to denature the restriction enzymes. This is a good opportunity to review the effects of heat on protein conformation and the importance of temperature in enzyme reactions. The ligase and ligase buffer that you will receive for Laboratory 3 will most likely come to you in a freezer box. These should be stored in your freezer at minus 20 degrees Celsius. When preparing reagents for Laboratory 3, it's important to resuspend your ligase buffer before aliquoting into your tubes for your students. These aliquots could then be stored in your freezer until the day of the lab. There is a 30-minute incubation time during this laboratory, so it is important to get the tubes into the water bath and then use this time to review content and have students work on their questions. Since there are fewer opportunities for hands-on activity during this laboratory, it is a great opportunity to review what they learned in Laboratory 1 about gel electrophoresis, since they will be using this technique in Laboratory 4. It is also a good time to review the industry connections and remind them where they are in the process of creating a protein. During this laboratory, it's important to stress to students that they keep track of all of their reagents. For this lab, they're going to be moving small amounts of liquid from one tube to another. A good tip is as they pipette from one tube, to move that tube to the back of their rack. So for example, they'll be taking a small amount of liquid from one of their plasmids that was digested, put it in the back of their rack, and add it to their ligation tube. After they've added that, close the ligation tube, put it back in their rack, and they want to get rid of their tip. It's really important to not contaminate any of the samples that they're going to be working with. And then the second step, they'll take another small amount of liquid from their second plasmid, put that in the back of their rack, denoting that they've already used it, open their ligation tube, and put that plasmid in. A typical ligation will incubate at room temperature overnight. Results will be visible during Laboratory 4. Students should hypothesize their expected results based on Laboratories 2 and 3.